So the theorem that we're going to prove is that if x is an integer and x squared is even, then x is even. And we're going to prove this by contrapositive. So let's first identify here the hypothesis. And that there are actually two parts to the hypothesis. The first one is that x is an integer, and the second part is that x squared is even. So the hypothesis is these two facts together. And the conclusion of this conditional statement is that x is even. And in a proof by contrapositive, we start by assuming the negation of the conclusion. And we have to prove that this hypothesis is false. It can't be the case that h1 and h2. So it can't be the case that x is an integer and x squared is even. So you actually only have to show that one of these two facts is violated. So we're going to assume also that x is an integer. And we're going to prove that it can't be the case that x squared is even. So you can prove for yourself on the side that these two logical expressions are in fact equivalent. Sorry, we need a negation here for H2. So if we assume that not C and H1, then that implies not H2. So let's write this out now in English. Then assume if X is odd and X is an integer, then X squared is also odd. And the reason that we're doing a proof by contrapositive is that it's actually easier to work with the fact that x is odd than to work with the fact that x squared is even. If x squared is odd, then we can express it. The definition of being odd is that x can be expressed as 2k plus 1 for some integer k. And if we were to do a direct proof, what we'd have is that x squared is equal to 2k for some integer, and that wouldn't give us a value for x that we could then plug into something. We'd have to take the square root. So if we started with this statement that x squared is even, we'd get that x squared is 2k. And in order to get an expression for x, we'd have to take the square root of this, which wouldn't necessarily help us figure out that x is even. So the proof by contrapositive is easier because now we have an expression for x that we can work with, and that's equal to 2k plus 1. And our goal now is to show that x squared is odd. So the logical next step is to take this expression for x and to square it and see what we get. So x squared, and now I'm going to plug this in, 2k plus 1 squared. And if I multiply this out, I get 4k squared plus 4k plus 1. Now the goal here is to show that x squared is odd. And the only thing that we know about odd numbers is that they can be expressed in this format as 2k plus 1. Or some integer k. So I want to take this expression that I have for x squared, and I want to express it as 2 times an integer plus 1. So here's my plus 1, and now I want to take the rest of this expression and re-express it as 2 times an integer. So I'm going to factor out a 2 from these two terms, 4k squared and 4k. So let's see what happens. And there I have it. I know that this part here is an integer. 2k squared plus 2k is an integer since k is an integer. So now I've taken x squared and I've expressed it as 2 times some integer plus 1, and therefore x squared is odd.